17, and I once killed a boy with a Fender guitar. I don't remember if it was a Telecaster or a Stratocaster, but I do remember it had a heart of chrome and a voice like a horny angel. I don't remember if it was a Telecaster or a Stratocaster, but I do remember it wasn't at all easy. It required the perfect combination of the right power chords and the precise angle from which to strum. The guitar bled for about a week after, but the blood was dark and rich, like wild berries. The blood of the guitar was Chuck Berry red. The guitar bled for about a week afterward, but it rung out beautifully, and I was able to play notes I'd never even heard before. So I took my guitar and I smashed it against the wall. I smashed it against the floor. Smashed against the body of a varsity cheerleader. Smashed against the hood of a car. Smashed against the 1981 Harley Davidson. The Harley howled in pain. The guitar howled in pain. And I ran up the stairs to my parents' bedroom. Mommy and Daddy were sleeping in the moonlight. Slowly I turned. Step by step, I opened the door, creeping in the shadows right up to the foot of their bed. I raised my guitar high above my head, and just as I was about to bring the guitar crashing down upon the center of the bed, my father woke up screaming, "Stop! Wait a minute. Stop it, girl. What do you think you are doing? That is no way to treat an expensive musical instrument." And I said,